Welcome again, everyone, to this great effort here, June 30th, last day of the month. I usually try to just put an all-out effort so that we close the month with a great success. And we are getting that. We're certainly going to make this effort here. Now, I have asked the Holy Spirit for what's the topic here. Okay, there is a topic. It's an amazing topic. So we'll try to talk about it in the mood of repentance. Very humble understanding. We have a severe continuity problem, which requires us to put all our effort on this, to remain calm and poised and non-argumentative and listening and manage our breakthroughs. And this is necessary because of the severity of our continuity fears and concerns. Well, blockbuster insight just came to me. Blockbuster insight, actually. It's very simple, but never thought of it before. Never thought of this before. It's a brand new consideration. Wow. Well, let's have a go at it. Let's say there's a bottle here. Look at the bottle. Now, the bottle is in space, isn't it? It's a space around the bottle. Now, as we're looking at the bottle, does the space define the bottle, or is the bottle defining the space? Which is it, more or less, you know? And I think that we will find that things we, the way we deal with our perception, is that things are defining space for us. Because things are important to us. This water keeps us alive. So, we're primarily focused on the thing and the things. And therefore, the space of this thing, we don't give it much thought at all, but we might just have a sense, well, it's just, you know, a little area around here, an area to grab it. You know, I can get a hold of this, I can get a hold of that. This is the space that my body can interact with whatever things are. We tend to think of space as the area in which we can get things, interact with things. Okay, that's it. Now, the Holy Spirit has suggested in a previous video that the little shift we make is to recognize that there's infinite space around everything. Space extends infinitely, right? Now, this is an intermediate step. Ultimately, there's pure spaciousness, but we're not worried about that at this point. We're not focused on that. We're going to use space, as it were. The infinite amount of space around everything, right? Okay. That's true. Obviously, it's not just a little space that we're using to grab hold of something. The space actually extends in all directions throughout the universe. Okay, from each object, each thing, apparent thing, anything that our attention can rest upon, even thoughts. Now, the Holy Spirit just suggested something to me which takes it to another level. So we can at least look at this. It's such an amazing concept, but we do have to speak somewhat mundanely about it. The space right here, extending infinitely, this space right here, this space right here, this space here, is not this space one seamless universal space? Is this not universal space right here? Is this not right here, this space? Is this not universal space? One universal space. Okay, what do we mean by that? Well, where's the seam? Where's the boundary? Is not this space seamlessly connected to all other space, for instance, on this planet? Isn't all space on this planet one space, actually? Theoretically, I mean, of course, we can say the space inside this thing is, you know, not one with the space outside. And then you get into pure spaciousness, when in fact it is. But for the sake of getting a sense of what we're talking about here, certainly, the space does not have parts to it, does it? So the space right here, the space right here, is a continuum with the space everywhere. It's a continuum with the space everywhere. So this space that we're seeing right here is a one universal space. This space is one with all the space in the entire universe. We're touching, we're in, abiding in universal space. Whether this bottle has space trapped inside of it or not, it is still abiding in universal space. That doesn't change at all, does it? Does that mean the space inside this is non-universal space? No, because you could say, if you want to give it a different delineation of the space inside this bottle is also surrounded by universal space, isn't it? If you want to make space an object, all right, which the mind will say, here's a trick. If you want to make space an object, that's fine, but it too is dwelling in universal space. So space is also dwelling in universal, the one universal space. Bottom line is, there is this, we are dwelling right now in the one universal space, and we're, this is it. This is it. Everyone is. We think now that this is space, the space is right here in this area, and it's different than the space over there, and it's different than the space over there, because we're used to thinking in terms of things and our interaction with things, and well, that the neighbor, that's the neighbor's space over there, right? That's somebody else's space. Yeah. Well, that's open space. That's a city space. So we're used to defining space as ownership, right? But does space have actual boundaries to it like that? Is space truly owned like that? Now you might say, don't go into my space, I own this space, you can't come into this space. But is not the space, for instance, over the neighbor's yard, is that not the space, one seamless space with the space right here? And is the space right here not a seamless space with the space over there? And that space over there, is that not a seamless space with the space up there? And the space up there, is that not a seamless space with all the space in the solar system? And the solar system is one with all the space in the galaxy and all the universe. Therefore, it's all one space. And that means this space right here is the one space. This is the one space. You never leave it. So we're cosmic beings. From the standpoint of space, which is what is all around us, we're not world beings, we're cosmic beings entirely. We are surrounded by cosmic space, one cosmic space, one seamless cosmic space. We're in it. So this is just dawning. It's just dawning. There's some objections are being thrown up, etc., but it's fine. Don't try to answer them. That's part of the continuity fear. You should know that. When quibbles come up, it's continuity fear. Don't try to answer those questions. They'll go away. Once the continuity fear dies down, they'll go away. So I'm saying literally that this space right here is entirely cosmic, entirely universal. It is one with all universal space. It's not different than it. It's not other than it whatsoever. This space is literally one like solid ocean, one vast ocean, one universal ocean of space. And we're in that ocean. There's nowhere else to be. We're in the universal ocean. We're not trying to get into it. We're in it. And the thing is when we define ourselves by things and the utility of things and how to get them and stuff, and we're focused on that, we keep thinking that we're not in it and we need, how do I get into this, you know? How do I get into it? I need to meditate? How do I get into this? How do I get into the universal space again? How do I do that? As if we're not in it. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. We're already in it. Yeah. One minute. Now, it is a fact that we are so focused on things that feed our senses, food, whatever, that we only see the space that's involved with us directly getting to that food and eating the food, right? And we never consider that this is actually universal space. All space is universal space. We think, no, it has all these boundaries. It only extends a little ways. You know, I only need it to extend a little ways to get that food. You wonder why these religions have fasting and various things like that. To stop trying to get anything, do anything, get anything. You just sit quietly there. And then it's easier to think along these lines because you're not trying to see anything from a utilitarian standpoint of grasping it, of getting it, of possessing it, of eating it, of drinking it, anything like that. Now, the sacredness could quite possibly come from realization that this is universal space that is here. This is not planet space, this is not personal space, this all space is universal space. It's the entire body of the universe is of space is right here, right now. Coming out of this delusion that space is somehow segmented based on things is to come into maybe something such as the vision of oneness. We'll have to see. Certainly would help. Certainly would help. Holy Spirit is moving us in this direction, so. Again, space is seamless. So you cannot say that this space right here is different from the space across the universe, or any space in the universe. The space here is exactly the same as the space anywhere else. I'm not talking about atmosphere, but space. The spacing, spaciousness. It's exactly the same, right? Drama playing out there with a cat. As there often is, right? So what we're doing, we're just bringing up this recognition. We're not trying to rush into it, okay? We don't need to rush into it. Don't need to rush into it. It's enough to bring it up. And I'm just saying, yeah. I can see that's accurate and amazing. We haven't seen that, isn't it? Amazing. But this here is universal space. This space right here is universal space. It is one with the totality of all space in the universe. Now, I got a feeling when this blossoms, this is going to be something, something really. I'm like someone who's groggily waking up. I'm saying, the idea just came to me, so I'm kind of just saying, wake up, trying to blink my eyes and wait, you know, wake up here. What? Open your eyes. The universal space. Well, where? Here. It's here. It's here too. It's here. So as we walk through the world, are we not walking through universal space? Or as we moving, isn't everything moving through universal space at all times? Now, at this point, I don't know how this is going to play out. I just have faith and listen to what the Holy Spirit says. It's never thought about before. Never. And I can see it's quite true. This is not, you know, this is not bottle space that we're dealing with here, right? This is not bottle space. This is not the best example because it's got a space air inside of it. There's a lighter space. Incense. Okay, some incense. This incense is, this space is not incense space. It's total universal space. But at this point, you know, it's such a fresh idea, you know, I don't want to try and struggle with it too much, really. It's like a seed that's been dropped in now to the consideration. Let's see how it grows, right? Now, am I so unimportant that, I mean, I'm literally dwelling in a universal space here. Everything is. We're thinking that we're dwelling in our own little space here, and then others are dwelling in their own little separate space. But none of this space is separate at all, is it? None of this space is separate. So nobody is dwelling in a separate space, in separate space, actually. Again, don't struggle with the quibbles. I'm trying to raise some quibbles here. What about space in a jar and things like that? Those are quibbles from the continuity fear, for sure. Silly, silly stuff. So don't even entertain it. Don't try to answer. I can see that when this starts sinking in, it's going to be very profound. Because this space, you know, right here, is literally universal space. Not figuratively, literally, because it's all one. It's all one body. There's not different parts to it. Everywhere it is the same one body. So this is an instance where some great realization like this comes, but I'm kind of like saying, well, I'm not sure what it means. You know, it's here, that's great, but exactly how does this play out, I don't know. So you just remain calm, don't struggle. Understand we have a severe continuity fear. Don't entertain quibbles. Okay, that's very important. Maybe you get pulled down. Objections are bound to arise. What about this? As if you're supposed to explain it all right this instant. No, it's a new idea. It's a new idea. So you don't have to be brilliant about it right off the bat. We don't have to have all the answers right off the bat. We're just, you know, groggily opening our eyes to this amazing fact. That's the first step, isn't it? Open your eyes. And blink a little bit. It's like, huh. This. Or even if you don't see it right now, it's okay. As long as the idea is registered. I say, okay, the idea is registered here. The idea is registered. We're so used to not seeing it that way, right? We're so used to seeing like space as flat, aren't we? When I look, because we always look at space, we're looking at something that space stops there when we see that thing. That's like the end of the space, isn't it? Even like if we see a mountain, space seems to stop there at that mountain. So space always seems like flat, that it stops somewhere. But in truth, it doesn't stop anywhere. And we are literally breathing, you know, not breathing down, we're breathing the air, the gases in space. But we are literally abiding in this space. It doesn't stop anywhere. That's seamless, that's infinite, that's seamless. All one, we're in it. So it's important to note that when you get some incredible insight, it doesn't have to be some, you know, lightning flashing and running down the street, eureka. You kind of just say, wow, okay, I see it, but I'm not really sure what it means. And yeah, gradual waking up process, that's the way it should be. Be very ultra conservative about it. Just okay, be very ultra conservative. In your reactions, ultra conservative in your reactions. Maybe some people are screaming, you got it, you got it, you got it. Yeah, I know I got it. There's no question I got it, but so I still have to open my eyes to it. There's no question that this is significant. Yeah, I can tell, I know it's significant. Again, ultra-conservative reactions. Now, am I looking at things differently? No. No. Nothing's changed. Do I feel different? No. Anything seem different? No. But I get a sense that this is going to dawn. This is going to dawn on me here. It's the beginning of the dawn. So everything's still dark, but the beginning of the dawn is like you look at the mountain and you look carefully and then you can see, I see this tinge in the sky. It's the beginning of the dawn. And you know in a little while the sun's coming over that ridge, right? Yeah, but right now it's still essentially dark. It's kind of like that. I can tell that this insight is the lifting of the veil. Okay, it is the lifting of the veil. But the veil, you know, it hasn't quite lifted yet, but probably soon it's going to lift. Hopefully soon. That should be very interesting from now on. Of course, we're used to the dark. I'm used to viewing space. We take space for granted, don't we? We don't even think about it. It's just something that just happens to be there around things, and that's it. We don't realize we're in the very presence of total universal space right now. We're in the presence of it. Does not this space know all things? Does it not know all things? Is it not around, surrounding all things in the entire universe? Within and without, as it were, but is it not surrounding all things? Does it not know all things? The space that surrounds something, is it not aware of the form of what it's surrounding? Is it not surrounding everything in the entire universe right now, this space? It is, isn't it? This space right here that's surrounding everything here is at the exact same moment surrounding everything in the entire universe. It's important to be very ultra conservative here, because you're going to think like, hey, I got this great insight and I'm not even reacting to it very much, and I'm just, everything still seems the same. And you might think, what's wrong with me? No. Expect the ultra conservative reaction to it. That's what the Holy Spirit told me before. He gave me one word, ultra conservative. I said, what do you mean, ultra conservative? He says, you'll see. I said, okay, I'll be ultra conservative, that's fine. Well, this is an ultra-conservative reaction to this incredible insight. Incredible truth that's just been, you know, pointed out to me. It was just pointed out. The Holy Spirit just pointed it out, and just like an instant, I just said, hey, I said, what are we going to do with this taping? And the Holy Spirit said, well, do you realize that this space is actually seamless everywhere? I said, huh? I said, yeah. All right. That'd be ultra conservative about the realization of that. And the truth is, we've been looking upon the space like it's nothing, like it's no importance whatsoever. It's giving, you know, that's the amazing thing, isn't it? I'm still looking upon it that way. It's not even, you know, aware of the space, really. It's almost like a shadow. We don't hardly pay any attention to it. It's like the shadow of everything. We don't pay attention to the space. But isn't space like the most obvious thing that there is in the world? It's like the skin of the whole universe. I mean, it's everywhere. It doesn't seem very utilitarian to us, but if it weren't for space, there wouldn't be anything, right? Because space allows objects to exist, doesn't it? There has to be some space, you know, between this bottle and the wall. Or how could you have a bottle and a wall? You know, there's no space. Now, those who recognize this, somehow they're going to feel like they're surrounded by unbelievable riches or something. It's just, and other people think they're nuts. What are you talking about? I don't see anything here. It's amazing, right? Just like that. We don't see space as one, do we? We see it all fragmented. But it's not fragmented at all. So we'll just have to see if this idea takes root and starts growing and what the results will be. I think the important thing was to allow the seed to drop, you know, into the soil of my mind, my consideration, and we'll see what comes of it. Universal space too, isn't it? Now, people go to like places and they say, this, I gotta go sacred places. Well, isn't the space right here completely sacred? Right? I mean, it is the universal space right here, right now. Same everywhere. Is there any space that isn't sacred? If you want to call it sacred, is there any space that isn't? It is or isn't, it's all one. So, I think I should be getting more than I'm getting, but that's fine. No, again, ultra-conservative, going out ultra-conservatively, because I think it's such a huge, huge, huge insight. It's better to go at it slowly at first, so you don't, you know, this avalanche doesn't happen. Of insight, avalanche of insight, avalanche of realization. So I'm just going at it nice and slow, very slow. So we're looking in the wrong place the whole time. We're looking for some fantastic thing, some sacred thing. The whole time, it was right in front of our face. As Jesus said, nearer than near is the space. Is the space, actually. That's the great sacred object. in the universe. It's the one object, right? It's so I say, hello, space. Hello, space. Nice to meet you, space. Nice to meet you, universal space. Sorry I've been overlooking you all this time. I aim for a breakthrough today. I've been aiming for a breakthrough for today for a long time. And I said I had to get it. If I don't get it, I'm going to die. I'm going to do or die. I'm going to die trying. If I don't, you know, either I get it or I die trying. And this insight has come, you know, just towards the end of the day on the 30th of June, 2014. So it's a success. Not at all what I expected. I didn't know what to expect. This comes as a big surprise. You know, there's no bells and whistles and party poppers and streamers and horns and, you know, there's nothing like that. At least I'm gauging my reactions to this. At least I have accepted the idea, entertaining the idea, gauging reactions, you know, and getting familiar with it. Just staying ultra conservative with it. I think that's the message. The idea came, that's enough. Don't try to figure it out too much, just okay. The idea has been received. You know, got it. 10-4. Got it. Just sleep on it, I guess I would say. Just sleep on it, yeah. Again, playing it ultra-conservative. Ultra-conservative. Don't start to write a book. Don't start to write an essay. Don't start to speculate. Just, okay, idea came, great. This is the restraint that I've been talking about, the mood of repentance. This is why I'm telling you it is so important. It's been so successful. If you want to know the road to success, this is it. Because it puts you in this ultra-conservative mindset, okay? Minimize your actions, minimize your reactions, minimize your struggle, minimize your responses to any quibbles. You say, no, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. Vision of oneness is the answer to the continuity problem. And so you stay in this ultra-conservative mindset, and this enables these great answers to come. Because you feel you don't need to do too much with them. You don't need to struggle with them. You just accept them along with everything else in equanimity. And yet they're here, been accepted. It's like all these stones are being laid out in front of a table, and you're there, and you're just in the mood of repentance. And someone keeps putting stones, laying out stones on the table, and just say, whatever laid out on the table, fine, I'm not going to move. And then they start laying out these gemstones, and you just, same. First it was just dull rocks. Gradually the rocks get more interesting, crystals, gemstones of types, and then diamonds start being laid out, gold, diamonds, jewels, beautiful jewels, and you're still just sitting there, saying, mood of repentance, not grabbing anything. And yet you're seeing what's there, you're just not grabbing anything. Say, okay, I see you there. Set in front of me, but I'm just sitting there. Don't grab it, okay? Now, if you didn't have this mood of repentance mindset, when they start sending out little gems, you're gonna suddenly go, oh my God, I gotta have that, and you grab it, and you take it, and you run off, and that's it. And you miss everything else that is coming, everything else. All these little gemstones are designed to get you more and more used to melt the continuity fear so the big gemstones can come and the big mountain of gold, the big pile of gold can be given unto you. So don't try to grab or grasp anything or struggle with it too much. You can look at it. Sure, look at it. Comments, oh, this nice, nice gold pile. Very nice gold pile. Very nice idea. I like the idea a lot. Resonates very strongly with me. But just let it sit there. Just let it sit there. Don't have to do anything with it. So, as the great sages say, if you want to be enlightened very quickly, sit quietly. I call it sitting in the mood of repentance. Practice that. Far and away, and of course that's based on acknowledgement of the continuity problem. I have a severe continuity problem. There isn't any other problem. And I know the remedy is a vision of oneness, and I have to sit here humbly in the mood of repentance, and knowing that I have these reactions, and I have to manage these reactions. I have to be ultra-conservative and sit here quietly. That brings you along the path in a very, very, very rapid way. More rapid than reading spiritual books, for sure. Harilal Punjaji said, they asked him, if I wanted to be enlightened, really quick, what's the way? Just sit quietly. Just sit quietly. Don't say anything. Just sit quietly. You can, if you need to say something, you can. Just sit quietly. Very quietly. Just sit quietly. That's what'll do it. So, this is true. This is very true. But we're kind of like polishing this and giving, some very clear context to it. Mood of repentance. Do it based on the continuity fear. Because when that pile of gold shows up, you're going to say, whoa, yeah, wow, I got a continuity issue, with that, wow. I'm not used to that. I thought there was just a little bit of space here, personal. I didn't realize I was in the presence of universal space, actually. that we're in the presence of universal space right here, everywhere. This isn't just space. This is the space of the entire universe is right here. This universal, total cosmic space. We're in it. This is the same space that is touching every planet, every sun, everything existent in the entire cosmos. And the cosmos of cosmos, it is... We'll just leave it at this universe. That's big enough for us, okay? It's big enough. It's touching everything. It's surrounding everything. This is the space. This is it. This is the great ocean. We're in the great ocean. We're in the great ocean. So is everybody else, right? So when you see someone else, when you realize this, you see somebody else, how are you going to view them? Very differently, right? When you realize the awesomeness, the preciousness, the awesomeness, the sacredness, the incredible, amazing fact, you realize that person over there, they're in the same ocean as you are. Same ocean, the cat, the tree, everything. I think it's most profound, though, in terms of other people. I mean, it makes their personality quirk seem completely irrelevant, doesn't it? If you are surrounded by this universal cosmic space, are you not a universal being? Are you not a universal being? How could you not be? Is not the space that is surrounding you that's got your form? It is around all your form right here. Is that not universal space? So and it does not have an impression of you. So are you not a cosmic being right now? Are you not a universal being? It isn't all just this one universal being right now? All is universal being right now. Now, they may not know that. They may think they're in personal space. So you may have a much higher view of them than they have them of themselves, for sure. Force anything or struggle with anything, or just whatever comes up is fine. Whatever comes up is fine. Just let the insight grow. Let it grow. Let it grow. So, great. Very great. I needed this for sure. Needed this for sure. Need rapid growth of this too. But I just have to let it grow how it grows. this is not yard space, house space, street space, town space, city space, county space, country, state space, country space, continent space, world space, solar system space, galaxy space. This right here is universal space. Sovereign, completely free, unattached. One seamless, unattached, freely resting upon everything in the entire universe. That is this space right here. And we get conditioned through our sensory perception and this body and everything, and everybody else with their sensory perception and their body, where we get born into a situation where nobody sees this. Everyone is completely over-identified on utility, and nobody sees this except the sages. So we're all trying to, you know, wake up and be sages, absolutely. In fact, we already are. We're cosmic beings. We're universal being right now, actually. We're surrounded by universal space. We're dwelling in universal space. All our friends are dwelling in universal space. Everyone is dwelling in universal space. How could we not be? Aren't we blessed? Because every single person on the planet is dwelling in universal space right now. Everything is. We live in this world. The whole world's dwelling in universal space. Everything here is dwelling in universal space right now. Are we not totally blessed? I mean, is this not fantastic? Yeah. So it'll, you know, it'll start dawning. So very great. I just. So when this starts to insides bubble up, let them bubble and don't struggle. Let it bubble, don't struggle. Let it bubble, don't struggle. And when the bubbles pop, 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 okay, fine. Then don't struggle. Don't shake the bottle. Where's the rest of it? It'll effervesce on its own. Effervescence here. Effervescent insight. Let it bubble, don't struggle. Effervescent insight. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so. So the idea that we got to get somewhere to be important, that's gone, is it not? The idea that we're somehow insignificant in some little corner of the cosmos tucked away, separated from those, that's gone, is it not? How are we insignificant? This is the cosmic space right here. I'm in it. Everyone's in it. How are we insignificant? How can anyone possibly say that? Are we not equal to everything there is? Is it not everything equal, equally surrounded by the one cosmic space here? Yeah. What is insignificant? Is that even true? Now, it's interesting, I do my tapings outside. It's outside. So I can feel the space, you know. It's not like in a room that's walled off, which tends to throw us off for some reason. We're not going to struggle with that at this point. A lot of meditation is done outdoors, right? You have a little porch, a little place, a little meditation area, a little contemplation. So you can sort of feel, sense that this space is all seamless, right? You may not notice it, but some moment it may dawn upon you. It's kind of the end of dogma and rituals, is it not? Seeing this? There's nothing you need to do. It's already true. It's already present and true entirely for everyone. You don't need to set up some little area and say, okay, this is a sacred space. I'm doing rituals in the sacred space to make this. It's already, you're already cosmic citizen, cosmic being. We're all cosmic citizens right now. We don't need to fly to some other planet or some other place or whatever. There's only cosmic being. Everything in the universe is cosmic being. So what's happening is the vision of oneness is being brought through, you know, to the conscious level here. And not as just a fleeting insight, but as a overall realization. So that's great. Needs to, you know, accelerate. And so I'll let this sink in and go about my business and just keep focusing, keep on with the urgency here. So, very great. Here we go into July. As I said, we want to be done by July of 2016, right? So we got 2 years from now. 2 years from now for the dawn to come. 2 years from now to recognize this, have some recognition, somehow something sets in that you're aware that you are, everyone is cosmic being right now, already. We don't have to make ourselves that. We are that. Everything is that already. So 24 months, 2 years, 24 months before the cult of personal space gets too strong. It can never really get too strong, can it? But it certainly can seem to get too strong. That's for sure. That is for sure. Okay, so here we go into July 1st, 2014. Very great. That's it.